Hello. So welcome to another episode of Career Conversations. Now, today I had thought that there's a lot of ambiguity in the market amongst aspirants about the CPA course and the US CMA course. So I thought I'll bring on board an expert and make you hear from the horse's mouth. So Shripal Jain has been kind enough to consent to come on the Career Conversations show. And he's a chartered accountant and a CPA. And after a good stint in the corporate world, he is now full-time into CPA education in Hyderabad and is the exclusive provider of Becker training material in India. So welcome to the show, Shripal.
Yeah, thank you, Anurag. Thanks for calling me. It's a pleasure being here. Thank you.
Yeah. So, you know, our viewers have a lot of queries about CPA specifically. Before that, I would want to know a bit about your journey. So you completed your CA in the year 2011 and you worked at the likes of an Infosys, Virtusa, Tech Mahindra with a brief stint at EY also. So in IT per se, because you primarily worked in IT, how is the role of a chartered accountant? Is it rich enough from an intellectual standpoint, or you just end up supporting the tech guys who would be the so-called breadwinners for the family?
So basically, see, Infosys have kind of made me learn a lot of things. So when I was in Oracle, so I started my career as an Oracle functional consultant at Infosys. And then I moved to business finance later by kind of dropping a mail to CFO that I'm not so happy with the consulting role and I wanted to move into core finance. And I think Deepak was there at that time, who was the SVP Infosys, and he took my interview and I then shifted from Oracle to the core business finance team of Infosys. So I got a great boss in Infi, Rajesh was there. So he helped me in each and everything as we were a new team that time. And I learned a lot in function like finance, and he actually made me to learn new ideas and think kind of out of box in reporting, planning and analysis. I feel a lot of them are not aware of the organization structure when they join any of the organization. It's important you understand the structure, and that's the trick to excel in profiles like business finance, right? Same goes with TechM, and EY kind of made me ultimately sound technically, and the work pressure kind of helped me a lot because in EY, you know how the big four pressure is, right? So you kind of become very, very technically sound, and you are able to manage. If you are able to manage the work pressure, I think that's kind of a blessing in disguise for you, actually.
So, interestingly, you shot a mail to the CFO. So, didn't you have any, you know, inhibitions, reservations at how this would backfire? And
Basically, I was very clear that I wanted to do something which is relevant to my field. And that time I seriously didn't know that technology will have such a huge disruption what it has today, right? So that time I wanted to move into finance, and I was being assigned to a consultant role. I felt that if I drop a mail to a leader and communicate to him, so I just tried out, and the CFO kind of replied back that time. And he said, we are very happy if you move to finance and we would love to have you here. So, and that's where they conducted an interview and they sent me to do a presentation on Wipro versus Infosys. And they sent me to do a comparative analysis. And first they asked me for Infosys and TCS, and I wanted to talk only about Infosys because I'm in Infosys. So I selected, I wanted to do a presentation on Infosys versus Wipro. So I did a competition analysis that time and all, and I used to follow Rajiv Bansal commentary that time whenever the results are out. So a lot of the time our students don't see the commentary, they don't see the lot of the results which come out after the in the stock market, right? So the transcripts, earning transcripts and all, the interview calls and all. So they asked me a lot in that interview and I was ready for it. And I think that was kind of a terrific transformation what I had from the core functional, and I moved into a completely finance role. And then I went into complete finance domain with EY, Virtusa, TechM and all sort of thing. So I was seriously not fearful when I dropped the mail to the leader because I was very well aware that Infosys is known for its leadership and for corporate governance. So I think I took an advantage of it, basically.
All right. Okay. So then after this corporate stint, I'm sure you would have made some impact in terms of your bank balances as well. One fine day, you quit this stable job and you started Simardhan Educations for CPA and USCMA. So before we discuss the specific queries I have on these two courses, tell me, was the transition to entrepreneurship easy? You know, quitting a stable job and starting Simardhan with a clean slate, no bank balances. What was the journey like?
So I always wanted to teach. I mean, as I was associated with examiner in ICI, and I was also the visiting faculty at Geetham and Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. And then I was with Tapasya Academy, which is a very popular institute in Hyderabad. So I used to skip my office also for first 2 hours and in TechM and teach the students. And one fine day I realized I can't do the multitasking and thought I must do things which I like. So my entire family kind of supported me in my decision, starting from my brother, sister-in-law, and I just got married that time. And I felt that it was a tough decision, but my wife was a chartered accountant too. So that made things a little easier for me. And I felt a lot of the CA students were not getting through when I was teaching them, and also half of them whom I passed, they went into the final and then they kind of couldn't crack it after so many attempts. So I realized that somewhere there should be an international course which is shorter in duration and they can pursue these courses even after passing them. So, and they can pursue CA along with CPA and CMA. And I feel a lot of the qualified CAs also lack the specialization and all, and jobs, they are not so good when they are coming up after the qualification. So I feel your platform is helping a lot actually for all of them to get jobs. And also thanks to you for helping our fraternity and the CA job portal which we have created. I think that's a terrific measure of helping the qualifieds get the right jobs.
Yeah, so my wife Sonia is working on this and doing quite a fantabulous job that way. Okay, so now coming to the specific questions. So when you talk about CPA and USCMA, I am more interested first in the CPA part. So what is the course perception, you know, in the eyes of the Indian HR? Because you also deal with the placement dimension of the CPA. So do they really value in the Indian context CPA? What are the kind of roles that they offer in India and the kind of salaries, if you could give us some sense?
Sure. So I see Invesco offering FP&A, Big Force hiring, audit roles, Accenture and Capgemini in consultancy. So CPA and CMA USA, the scope is very good. Even Amazon off late is hiring a lot of CPAs and CMAs, and Big Force are also trying to go in more into the advisory role. You know the reasons for that, right? So due to the latest issues and all of ILFS and all sort of things, so Big Force don't want to take a risk of taking any attestation work. So they're expanding the team more in the advisory role, and thereby they are hiring a lot of, so this opens up opportunities for even non-CAs also. It's not just the chartered accountants, but it kind of opens up the options to all of them who all are not chartered accountant also. So not only with respect to CPAs or CMAs, but also all other accounting courses, that makes a huge opportunity because they are expanding like anything in the advisory role. So I see
offshore.
Yes, so a lot of global delivery centers of the Big Fours, the Big Fives and Big Six, say for BDO and GTs and all. So they're expanding their GDS divisions. Absolutely. Here. And I feel that this is a huge job opportunity, and it's a huge opportunity for all the people who are doing the international courses, not only CPA, CMA, I think SCA for that matter also. I see a lot of opportunities there. And typically the placements being hired, I mean, they are being hired at a package of around 6.5 to 7.5 lakhs. I know there are a lot of rumors that they get 10, 10.5 or 11.5 lakhs. You also know that. That salary is not a realistic figure for a fresher CPA. I would say 6.5 to 7.5 lakhs. So we place our students typically at 7 lakhs to 7.5 lakhs. So that is an ideal fresher salary without any of the experience. So that's the, I think that's a decent salary.
Absolutely, very good. All
right. I believe that the placement shall be the first priority of any institute. So whenever they are doing such courses, such Nikkei courses, I think placement is a huge responsibility for the institutes here.
Okay. And if I compare the demand for CPAs in India with the demand abroad, so does CPA have a vibrant demand abroad? and in which territory. So, for example, if I'm in India and I do a CPA, can I get a job in Singapore, Dubai, or US, Canada? Are there visa issues? Do I need to get a permanent residence, PR as they call for Canada or Australia?
So typically Singapore, I think Singapore hires CPA like anything. So, but the rule of Singapore is that you need to have 3 years of work experience. Without 3 years of work experience, they don't sponsor for the work visa. So Singapore is very clear and they hire a lot of CPAs. There's a huge demand because it's a finance hub after all. So Singapore, there is a huge job opportunities. And the job opportunities are tremendous in Canada. And also the immigration is very lenient in Canada. The rules and all are not so stringent what you have in Canada. US, definitely there are H-1 visa issues of Trump and all. So you might go on a visitor visa and then shift your visa to a student visa or do such things. But that's a little risky in US. So I would say right now you can move to Canada and then shift it to US. So the opportunities are a lot for the CPAs. Even I'm seeing that a lot of the Indian chartered accountants are doing US CPA and then shifting to Canada, because our Canadian CPA kind of restricts them only to the Canada location, but US CPA kind of opens them to Australia, New Zealand and all because of the reverse MOUs being signed up. So they have a lot of reverse MOUs signed up with Australia, New Zealand, UK, Scotland. Lately they have actually also there is a lot of opportunities in various other regions also. In Dubai also I'm seeing that they are hiring a lot of CPAs there, so there's a huge demand. The visa is definitely not an issue except for US, to be honest, because in US there is an issue of visa which is coming up. But again, in US also they are seeing if you have an accounting and a technical skill like RPA, robotic process automations, or blockchain, or Blackstone technology, or sort of things, or SAP for that matter. So they are actually sponsoring also for your visa in US. But preferably, I think technology is an important element to add up with an accounting course.
Oh, so that's an interesting thing, because nowadays, so there would be specific ways in which I can equip myself with technology like blockchain or artificial intelligence, yes, or RPA.
The noise of blockchain and AI is really true, and they are hiring a lot of accounting come technical guys in US. So I happened to meet one of the vice presidents of a few companies there in US, and I keep talking to them because I process their licensing of CPA. So when I talk to them, they say, Shripal, I need accounting and technical skills both, because I want a person to know SAP, or he have an SQL query languages knowledge, or if you have RPA. So a lot of them, they are hiring who have a technical and accounting skills, because accountant will understand the interface tables and all those sort of stuff, right? When the technology is being implemented, because a lot of the companies are implementing AI, blockchain and all in their finance functions. So they need an accountant who understand the technology and who understand how the data is being inputted and what is the logic behind that inputting of the data. So that's where I think there is a definitely a huge demand for CPAs come account, come technical skills like blockchain, AI and all other stuff.
All right. So that's quite an insight. Now for the CPA, now what I understand is that if I have 15 years of continuous education, that is just the 3 year graduation after my class 12, that doesn't qualify, because CPA needs 16 years of continuous education. Is that true? And if I'm a CA inter, does it make a difference, or a CS inter or a CA?
So nothing like that. They can do bachelor's and they'll be still be eligible for various states. So nothing like one state. So when we see the mark sheet, we recommend them accordingly. We feel that an institute offering CPA course shall have very strong expertise in evaluation. And that's the area we focus a lot and kind of help students in everything, starting from application to logistic and assisting them and placing them and all sort of stuff. So it's not that 16 years of education. Typically, it works like every year gives you a 30 credits. So our BCom ideally give 90 credits only. For a CP exam, you need 120 credits. But there are a lot of states who don't have 120 credit rule also. So we typically push the students for those states and then later transfer those credits to another states where they want or they love like. Right.
Oh, so for example, how does it, like if it's like Arizona, it will be different and something like that?
Yes. So Arizona have a CPA different requirements. So Arizona comes out with 120 requirements, and then you have certain states like California, or for that matter, New York, and also they have 150 requirements. So every state have their different credit requirements, right? So bachelors typically are ideal for some of the states, but we need to see what is their subjects like, because they typically need to have accounting and business courses in their curriculum. So that is what they prefer more. And some of the universities like Delhi University doesn't have accounting subjects more. So the bachelors there are short of CPA. So we push them to do a bridge course parallelly and then make them sit for the CPA exam. So they can do a bridge course and they can still sit for the CPA exam. There is a rule that within 18 months, they need to meet the balance credits. Parallelly, they can sit for the CPA exam as well. So that gives an excellent opportunity even for a bachelor's to do the CPA course.
So if I'm CA Inter, does it make a difference in terms of these credits?
100%, because CA Inter gives him 30 credits. So IPCC Group 1 will give him 15 credits. Group 2 will give him 15 credits. So he gets 30 credits for IPCC, 60 credits for CA Final. Same goes for CS, ICWI and all. So typically all the three qualifications will give them the balance credits of 60. So it's a good opportunity who all are semi-qualified and who have left CA due to some reasons beyond our circumstances. So I think this is a terrific opportunity to do CPA also.
Okay. And what about the course? There are four papers. You can appear all four of them together in one go. And yes, is it like a lot of rectification like the Indian CACS, or is it conceptual case study based evaluation?
No, so this is not theoretical more. It's more practical and application oriented. They, in regulation, they tell you to file the forms also. Like we don't have in our exams that they ask you to file income tax return forms, right?
Yeah.
In CPA, they practically to file it. So there is 50% multiple choice question and 50% it is simulation. So where they ask you, they give you an essay type of question and then tell you to read from the BEAR Act and answer it. So that 50% which is case law oriented is an open book. It's an online authoritative literature where they can refer the literature and answer those. Or even without literature also they can answer it. But they make you to practice reading the BEAR Act, practice reading the questions and solve it in an analytical manner. Because that is more of an MCQ and objective based pattern in CPA. Not like theoretical and all. And I think ICA also have shifted to 30% objective now. So I think that's the way it would be in the future also for most of the professional qualifications. Conceptual knowledge will be very important then rather than just theoretical stuff.
And what is the passing percentage? Is it as unpredictable as CA or is it 50% plus kind? So you have a fairly stable chance.
I think CA is it's one of the toughest course and all. So they say, I know you're CA and I am as well. So typically it's like 5% in CA. Here it is like 55%. So out of 155 people pass. The reason behind that is the CPA exam can be written in any month. So there are only four exams. You can write any month the exam except for the closing of the quarter. You will have first 10 days only to write the exam. So there is a flexibility. So you can write in any month and you can pass the CPA exam and all. On the content front, the quality is awesome. But on the flexibility front, it goes way beyond chartered accountancy. And that's the reason why the success rate is a little higher in CPA than CMA, than CA.
All right. But for taking the exams, earlier I could go only to the US. Now they become more flexible. I can go to the Dubai center as well. Right?
Yes, but you can go to Dubai.
Do it in India.
Still. No, they will never allow it in India. The reason is then half the Indians will do CPA only. So that's what is a problem. And ICI also have their own limitations on it, right? So we don't want AICPA to come here and open up the centers and all. And also they are not so convinced with the infrastructure and all. Because they conduct their all exams in ProMetric. It's an online computerized based exam which they have a ProMetric and it requires certain infrastructure. So the MOU between AICPA and ICI have fallen down, right? So I think it would take a lot of time for CPA exam to come to India, but the news is that they might soon come in Nepal or Sri Lanka for that matter, but that is also just a rumor. So it's not a convinced kind of thing, but I think they are having certain options and all because China is going down because of Trump thing. So due to the lot of tariffs and all, so the business from China is going down like anything. So none of the Chinese candidates are writing CPA exam and all. So I think they are seeing India as a potential market now.
All right. Now, when we talk about the four subjects, so I would, from, you know, as a student, want to understand that, so let's say I'm a working professional, can self-study be sufficient, or do I need some sort of a professional coaching, or let's say where the Becker material that you have, what is the kind of difference that it makes in my success?
So we are partnered with Becker, so we are their partner, and we are also the channel partners of AICPA, which is American Institute of Certified Public Accountants. So we are their both partners. So Becker is like $2 billion company, and they invest $1 million in their product. So almost, if I need to be precise, they invest $3 million in the Becker product. So what the product does is, it is definitely recommended, because this is not an exam where you can just study by reading books, as it is computerized with 50% objective and sims of 50%, and you have an online authoritative literature where they tell you to write down the standard number also. They ask you to write accounting standard number or the section number. So you need certain practice with the software. So I think Becker has that. So they have the video lectures recorded. They have the software which can have an auto update feature. So typically, if ICI is doing any amendments to their materials, to the syllabus and all, it takes certain time of 5 months, 6 months. But Becker software like does it in 1 month and all, and they get everything updated and all. And they have like three, and they also have a kind of MCQs, which are unlimited MCQs and unlimited simulations and all. So they can practice a lot with the software. And apart from that, I think we are the only institute who are offering live classes also, 365 days. It's an online interactive classes also, which we provide via WebEx and Zoom along with our physical live classes. So I think a product like Becker kind of enhances and creates a kind of confidence in the student, because these days professionals cannot go to the physical classrooms. So they want to sit at home and kind of study it and all, because they don't have time. So due to certain various reasons, I think the Becker product has that recorded videos inbuilt in it and all. And there are a lot of mock tests also in the software. So I think Becker is like, so almost if I want to say like in US, if I want to draw an comparison. So out of 4 lakh CPAs, I think 2 lakh or 2.5 lakhs people might have prepared only from Becker. So it's like since 50 years. They are doing it for CPA. So this is like 50 years they are.
But so self-study, you want to? Self-study?
Self-study is really difficult, because then if you're just reading from the books, it won't serve the purpose because it's an online exam. So you need to practice the software a lot. If you don't practice the software, you'll not get a hands-on on the book, hands-on on the exam. Because it's a computerized thing, it's a new thing. And there are a lot of things in that. You would know how the simulation look like. You would need to practice that. And there is an Excel being given, calculator is inbuilt and all. So it's a completely different platform altogether.
All right. Now, USCMA is the new kid on the block on the academic front. So we had established sources like USCPA and ACCA. Now, what is this USCMA? For sure, it does not have placement options just as lucrative as a CPA. So where do you see that positioning in the market for a USCMA? Please give an honest answer.
Okay, you want an honest answer. So I think, to be honest, we are the only institute who are placing students, and that also through our strong corporate connects. So we are actually tied up with various companies and all, which I can't disclose it and all. So, but we do it through our various connections and all through corporates. But ideally, I know IMA also have taken up steps in placing. So IMA is like the institute for CMA, which gives the CMA certification. So they have taken up steps in placing the students, like they have done it in Amazon, but the packages are really less. So it's like 3.5 lakhs, 3 lakhs and all. So we are placing them at 5.5 lakhs, but again, we are doing it through our strong corporate connects. But there are some of the institutes who are just looting students by giving them false promises of dual qualification. If you write the CMA exam in like outside India, you get a CMA India qualification also, but that MOU have been dispensed off. So now you no longer have a dual qualifications with if you write a CMA USA outside India. And also some of them, they have given a rumor like there are more than 10 lakh rupees packages and all as CMA. I don't think so. That is correct. Actually, they typically get around 4.5, right? So that is so why we take it up CMA program is we want them to do CPA later. And also because the similar, the content two subjects of CPA are similar in CMA, and also they will have an certification, at least it is far better than VCOM. So in that way, I would say CMA USA is very good. So it enjoys, it's like the biggest management accountancy qualification of US. But ideally in India, it's currently, it is a downtrend. Just that we have our connects and all, and we are placing them. But I think IMA needs to take some stringent and very urgent action on this, because there are so many people doing up, but they're not getting placed through other institutes and all. So I think that is definitely a concern area for USCM.
Yeah, because, you know, USCMA has been projected as the thing. Means if you just cleared USCMA, and so that is some notion that really needs to be looked at through the prism of reality. Now, coming to the next question. Now, if I am already in the league of the triumvirate of either a CA, CS or a Indian CMA, so does CPA add value and how? And so if I go for MBA vis-a-vis CPA, how does that compare?
So I think we did an interview like a couple of days back with a Canadian CA who was a CPA there, US CPA, and she got a job in Canada and all. So I think CAs, if they want to go global and all, so US CPA is definitely recommended. Even CMA USA are getting job in Canada. Only the Indian market is a little dicey for US CMAs, but they are getting jobs in Dubai, Canada as well. Right, but the Indian market is on a very strong downtrend for CMA USS, because a lot of the companies are not aware. It's just that we are creating awareness by going to the corporates and all, but half of the corporate are not aware. But on the CPA front, I think there is a huge advantage for the CAs, because they can move to Singapore, they can move to Canada. So they get a global access, what they can't get in CA, because typically if they have a CA, they can just get a job in Dubai. Because we have a chapter also in Dubai. So Dubai, typically they would get it. But in Singapore and all, I think CPAs are playing a, CPA degree is playing a very good job. Even for that matter, ACC also, they're getting a good job in Middle East. In UK also, anyways, they have the opportunities. But in Middle East also, like in Dubai and Muscat and Oman and all, ACCAs are being preferred there. So in that way, I think these international qualifications are very good.
Especially, I think for people who are stuck in, let's say, CA inter, CA final, and their parents keep telling them that, or people around keep telling them that you're not sincere enough and you're not working hard. I think they should probably take a tab at try to do CPA, US CPA.
What's happening here is a lot of these CA institutes, they are creating a kind of image that you just need to do CA and all. If they fail also, they tell them to write again, like 5, 5, 6, 6 times they do their ICWI or IPCC and all. So they don't pass it in a shorter time, or like they take a lot of attempts to pass. I think definitely the institutes must educate them to do a alternative course, get the confidence back, and again do the CA course. But the problem is institutes don't want to leave them. And I've seen in Hyderabad, there's so many institutes doing that. In spite of students failing repeatedly, some of the institutes just take CPT, IPCC final fees together, even if you have not passed CPT also. So that's a kind of concerning thing. That's the reason why the awareness is not there of about other than CA and MBA courses. There are so many courses, not just CPA, CMA or ACCA. I think Enroll Agent is also one of the good courses, which is a US tax course. Right. So there are a lot of the courses. CISA is there. And I'm seeing a lot of internal audit also is going in huge scope. Risk advisory role is going up. Consulting role is going up. So students need to understand it's just not CA. There is life beyond CA. So they can definitely do another course, get a job, and then keep doing CA till their lifetime.
They always come back with enhanced confidence. So what is the total kind of a cost outlay for a US CPA?
So typically US CPA along with the fees and all, everything would cost you around 3.5 lakhs. So because the exam cannot be written in India, it needs to be written in US and in Dubai. So overall should be 3.5, including two trips to Dubai is what we factor. He'll go there first time, write two exams, come back, again go there, write two exams and come back. Typically all the four, it's a little tough, I would say, for a CPA.
Okay.
And CMA, 85,000 if you have a scholarship and all. But if you don't have a scholarship and if you're a professional and if you have finished a graduation, then 1.5 to 1.4 is the ideal number for the CMA exam overall costing.
So 3.5 lakhs, as you are saying. So that includes the cost of coaching. So how much is the cost of coaching there?
The cost of the training of the Becker product and typically is like 1,20,000. So that combines the entire. So what in CA we have like CPT, IPCC and final. So if you take that, that training itself comes around more than 2 lakhs, right? So I think CPA, you're just spending a lakh rupee for a training. So
120 is for this and then the rest 2.3 lakhs is for what?
So 1.8 is for the international exam fees if they write in Dubai. So that is the international exam fees. And another 70K or so is for Dubai stay and accommodation and tickets and all.
Okay. Okay. Cool. But still, I think for, let's say, 3.5-4 lakh rupees, if you're starting off at 7 lakhs at least, and you're getting out of that loop of failure that I'm not good enough and I'm not studying sincerely enough, I think that's at least a good thought. And then how does CPA compare with, let's say, ACCA or a DIP IFRS or a certificate course on Ind AS by the CA Institute?
So I would say CPA is like a power which gives you that you can open your own firm also in India, right? So you have a license, you can sign, you can do a lot of outsourcing services. I've seen a lot of CPA firms here in Ahmedabad and Mumbai, they're opening up. So a lot of the chartered accountants who are practicing CAs, I think if they do CPA, they can do some international work of US and they can do some sort of outsourcing here in Ahmedabad. And I myself are doing a lot of outsourcing work from US and signing the financial statements. So you have an opportunity of outsourcing stuff a lot. Right. Whereas when we compare to ACCA and all, so there are not many UK companies in India, but ACCA scope is really good in Middle East. But in India, I would say ACCA is not so popular. I would say CPAs definitely go ahead because there are a lot of US companies in India. You have Capgemini, you have Cognizant, you have Accenture, you have Wipro, you have Infosys listed in US, you have Wipro listed in US, you have Microsoft, Google, Cap. So almost every second company is a US company, right? So in that way, that's the reason why CPAs is a little better than ACCA is what I feel.
All right. And the PR, is it good to take a PR also once you've done the CPA, the Canada PR or the Australia PR?
So how this Canadian PR works here is, Anurag, is you need to write an IELTS exam and you need to kind of get above 8 score. And then you can go into the express entry route and then get a PR. So all the formalities you should do here and you study here only. When you go there, you should wait for at least 6 to 7 months to get a good job. So you should be mentally be prepared. I've seen a lot of them, they just tell that you'll go there and get the job. It's not like that. You need to be a little patient for first 5-6 months, you'll not get a job is what I understand from the Canada market. But after that, there is a huge job opportunities for the CPAs. Because they pay like heavily there and the promotions and all, the profiles also and the designations is a little higher, I would say. So in that way, you do the all the formalities here and all, and then you kind of shift to Canada.
What are the kind of salaries that you would have heard of in Canada? Or
Canada, it's like they are getting around what, 65 to 65 lakhs. So that is, that much they make. But then you need to consider that there is a taxation also, which is of almost 40% tax rate in Canada.
And so cost of just, living.
Yeah, and cost of living and all. But still, I think they would save out around 1.5 to 2 lakhs per month for sure. The fresh
that's a lot of money. All yeah. Right. So, interesting. We've done quite a detailed discussion as you being a subject matter expert in terms of, we met at the recent ICI Hyderabad conference on the digital space. So what are your final thoughts then? Two students, the youngsters who are watching this career conversations, what would be your message to them, both as a professional who's done CA, now CPA, now coaching students, helping them get placed? What would be that mantra which should be their final takeaway?
So student, I think getting the right skill is very important. So time and again, the technology is kind of disrupting the finance function. So it's important that along gone are those days where CA was the only course where you would get placed off and all. There are so many options. We have come in a modern age where I think digital marketing is getting more salary than a chartered accountant does. So the skill sets and the various options what you have is should not be limited to CA. I've seen a lot of the fuss that CA is having disrespect and all. It's a very popular course and all. So yes, it is. It is a terrific course. But then you would need to take the practical aspect also into the mind that if you're not able to clear something, just take a pause, do another course and come back and do the CA thing again. But what I'd suggest is a lot of the students are getting stuck there. They're doing IPCC, they're failing IPCC, but they're not making a move because of the lot of money which is involved, the investment which is involved in the international courses or other courses. So don't look for that, because if you see the return on investment is really high. So it's not just you just do a CA and you just get stuck there. And it's not like that we are anti-CAs, because I myself a chartered accountant, right? So I don't want you to leave CA, but then if you're getting stuck, I would say please do some another course which is of shorter duration, get a job, and then keep doing CP and CM in overness, keep doing CA, right? So after once you finish off this shorter duration qualifications and get a job of 7, 7.5, I think you are settled and you don't have a mental tension there that you're not settled in the career. So okay. I think this is an important point which we need to notice here.
Absolutely. I mean, you need to be in the success zone. I think that is one thing that why IPCC, there are people who are failing again and again in final, not just of CA, but let's say CS or ICWA, now known as the Indian CMA. So wherever you are stuck in a loop of failure, it is good to step back, get into something else, get your self-confidence back, you know, because success gives you back that self-confidence. And then maybe, you know, if your long-term dream had been to still continue that old course, please do it.
Yes, that's right. Final students are also getting failed. It's not only CS, I think Anurag, ICWA is also, if you just notice that a lot of the ICWA people are also not able to clear
the because final, of the... Yes, absolutely.
Yes. So I think, see, I am convincing a lot of the corporates. I just convinced Infosys, because Infosys always used to hire chartered accountants. So I spoke to the leadership team and I said that why don't you open up the options to non-CAs as well, to MBAs also for that matter if it is. The problem with MBAs, a lot of these MBAs are lucrative and all, except from IIMs and all or XLRIs. I think the other MBAs which you do it from the colleges and all, they are really costly, 4.5, 5.5, 6.5 lakhs, and then you get 15,000 per month. So I would say if you're doing an MBA, you better do it from a premier top colleges, else you better don't do MBA, right? So if that is an investment, if you're looking at 10 lakh, 20 lakhs, I would say 3, 4 lakhs going to CPA or CMA. I think that makes more sense. ACA, CPA, CMA or any of this course, or even for that NALSER, a law course also for that matter. So there are a lot of options that just not get sticked with CA or MBA. I think life is a lot beyond that. And even for that matter, even the technology courses are also these days giving a lot of scope and all. And for that matter, enrollment also, which have come of the US taxation course, I think that is also now coming up huge in demand actually. So students need to identify which are the other options apart from CA and MBA. It's a high time that they realize that this is not the only thing which they are doing. Mumbai, Delhi, Bangalore, already people are doing it. I think Hyderabad, the southern markets still are exploring that. I think this is the right time to kind of do these courses and get placed in the companies.
All right. Fascinating. So wonderful to have you, Shripal, on the show and share authentic insights about things. So, you know, you've really heard it from the horse's mouth. And I'm sure I'm leaving behind his LinkedIn connect and his coordinates so that, you know, if you've got further queries, you can always come back to him. So, Shripal, if there are viewers on this show who've got queries, they're going to connect with you on LinkedIn or maybe leave behind a message on the comment section. So if you've got a query which you want others as well to benefit from, the best way would be to leave a comment on this video and let us know whether this video really added value. So and the best way to do that is to like, subscribe, share this video with your near and dear ones, and you know that gives us a lot of motivation to keep creating these videos. Thank you, Shripal. Pleasure having you.
Same pleasure having you here. This is an excellent initiative, and thank you so much.
All right. Thank you.